The first time I met Chamillionaire, he was iced out grill, iced out chain. I mean, I thought this guy was a millionaire. He was standing next to this guy named Salim, but unauthorized. But anyway, we had this beat that actually, this was actually the first beat that had a bidden war. Jay-Z heard this beat, and I mean, I heard he was crazy. Thanks to Lenny S for that. But it eventually went to Chamillionaire or Universal, and my first platinum plaque. What's up, everybody? Looks like we're back here at episode 2. This will be the making of Chamillionaire's In the Trunk that featured on his 2015 album, The Sound of Revenge. It was track 2 on the album. Couldn't be more happier to be associated necessarily with that album. This was pretty crazy, a lot of luck, a lot of kind of weird things that happened to get that on that album, but it was placed, and by the grace of God, you know, one of the top, you know, one of the beginning tracks. It was even on the vinyl, so I remember when I signed like the single papers, I thought it was like, you know, video, but they had put it on like the vinyl as a single along with Ron Dirty and stuff like that, and I was just, you know, happy to be along with that collective of songs. It has some big producers on there. Shout out to Playing Skills. Shout out to Scott Storch. Shout out to Manny Fresh. You know what I mean? Shout out to Chamillionaire for making that happen. Also, shout out to the A&R of that album, Sal Gastella, and my manager, Tony Perez, Relentless Management. They make it the time, you know what I mean, for making it happen. But anyway, this beat, surprisingly, is not that complicated. Surprisingly, it just goes to show you that a lot of beats just depends on, I guess, what you're doing. So we can actually break down the beat. If you listen to episode 1, you will know kind of what I'm about to say next, and that is starting off with the kick. The kick obviously is, like I said, from a Just Blaze drum, you know, a Just Blaze, I believe, beat kit. So that's like, you know, I just use this particular kick in so many different beats. It just hits different. So you hear it dirty, sounds New Yorkish, East Coast, I would say. But it just sounds real dirty. Love his kick. It's called the Blaze Kick. The next part, originally the beat had a different intro on it, and I won't be playing that, but had a different intro on it, you know what I mean, and I ended up having to change it up, because they wanted to scratch the intro, so I ended up kind of like ruffling the beat in the beginning, just kind of like, you know, I was thinking like the Posse Deckard that I did, you know, where the beat just ruffled in the beginning, and ended up coming out to be this. And it's kind of weird because the weird that I did that because Chamillionaire ended up, you know, having this is the sound of revenge is the, I was just like, holy crap. Like, I was just like super shocked that, you know, he had kind of used that intro and like, this is, you know, the sound of revenge. Like, it was just like something that set off that album. Along with that Blaze kit, the next track, the next sound here, I used the BD2. It's like a stock 808. Like I said, at that time when I was making beats, I didn't really, you know, I was like teaching myself, you know, I didn't have anybody say, hey, use different type of 808s. I used 1808 for like every track, and it just happened to be, you know, I had added this one along with the Blaze kit. So this sounds, you almost kind of don't even hear it, but you do. I actually saw a performance he did in the club, like in like, I think it was like Scotland, and it was just beating. And I was just like, okay, well, guess it worked. The next sound here, it's like a shaker. I guess I use this in a lot of different beats, but I don't know. It just kind of has that different sound to it. The next sound, standard hi-hat. That's where I use this hi-hat and every beat that I did, no difference. Another part here is, you know, from some top secret files, I will say, is in a being a hit. It sounds movie. I was kind of like, okay, this is something that I can use. So it just has like that movie hit to it. And I just, you know, kind of ruffled it up a little bit. Like, just ruffled it when it, you know, when it played. So that was it. Something simple. Then I had like some, had some snares. And that's like that whole like drum line sound. That's just like, you know. I was always into like the military, kind of like, you know, the drum lines and theme sounds, and, you know, always trying to do scores and stuff like that. So when I hear big sounds like that, it just kind of makes me think it's cinematic. Swiss Beats, actually, he's kind of, you know, he uses a lot of drum line stuff. And that's kind of, like I said, I was taking inspiration from a lot of guys, but there's a lot of inspiration that just kind of using these drumline type sounds. But ended up just filling out, so if I put these two sounds together, you know, it just... And that was it. Literally. Ended up, I think, shuffling it up for this, like, for the breakdown here. So the next sound here, you see, I kind of, it's like a little drumline ruffle, and I just kind of like slapped it in there, you know what I mean? So you see here, I have like drumline 1, drumline 2, drumline 3, where I just kind of have like this. I actually had the idea for that when I did, I think it was like Jay-Z's Just Give It To Me, and I think one of Neptune's, like, I think the 8th bar of the hook or the verse or something, they just kind of had like this, you know, repetitive last bar. And that's how that came to be. Same thing with the kick, I just kind of like wanted it to, you know, follow that drum line to make the punch out a little bit more. At that time, I was kind of like always putting markers all over, like, hey, this is the chorus and stuff like that. So this little pattern is just like the chorus where I know, like, okay, that's the chorus. So I would track it out and stuff like that. Like I said, I was teaching myself how to make beats for years. No one ever taught me anything. You know, maybe I met a few other producers and stuff like that. Like I said, I had a someone named, actually this guy named Joe, he was like one of the first guys to make beats back at Pratt Institute for me when I was just rapping. And, you know, like I said, I knew nothing how to make beats. So, just had like a few people who might have taught me a few things, and that was really it. A lot of stuff I had to teach myself. Especially with Fruity Loops, because it was like, everybody, like I said, used MPCs. I was like the known name on how to make beats, but Fruity Loops was unknown to the world at that time, especially like 2000, what was it, 1 at the time. I had like Fruity Loops 3, so it was like, you know, one of the first Fruity Loops ever to come out. When I said, only, at the time, only person who was able to use that actually Fruity Loops was the Neptune, that I believe. And that is it. So we go to the next sound here. Straight Up Shaker. I kind of like that one because it kind of sounds like every time it goes, it's almost like a hand is actually moving the shaker, so that's what I did for that. Did a little different where I did the beat where it follows that same fourth pattern where it goes, you know, kick, clap, kick, kick, you know, something simple. Like I said, this beat surprisingly does not have a lot of sounds. Originally I had a sample of a voice was like, what? You know, and I actually took that out. I even had bass that I had took out as well. And then I believe Sal Castell hit me back and was like, hey, I think Chamillionaire wants you to add, like, because he had, like, a part in the beat where the last part of the chorus, and he's like, in the trunk, and he's like, And at the time, I don't think I didn't even bring that into Fruity Loops. At the time, I was using like Samplitude recording, so kind of like Pro Tools, and I just like played it in there, and then just like exported it and send it off. And, you know, ended up writing to whatever Chamillionaire did in that particular beat. It was like boom, you know, and that was it. And that was played off a Triton. But yeah, I have so many sounds that are just like straight up Triton sounds in here. But yeah, the beat's real simple. The beat's not complicated. It doesn't have so many different sounds into it. That's really the beat. So if you just play the beat, it's just like, you know, if you play the beat. People might have heard this story about this particular track that, you know, this track actually had a bit of more behind it. Jimmy Iovine had bidded on this particular track against Universal, because at the time, I don't know, it was like Universal, they just wasn't sending the money for some reason. I was like, what is going on? So we ended up sending it over to an artist on Interscope named Brasco. He records the song. I mean, it was a smash hit. Jimmy Iovine wanted that beat so bad. They had offered more money and everything, but like I said, it was a bit more, but luckily, you know what I'm saying, Chamillionaire finally came through, and that's what kind of like got the hype behind the track. Like I said, Lenny S had played this particular Brasco's actually version of the song for Jay-Z, and I heard Jay-Z's response was just bananas. So this track had a lot of people talking about this particular track. It got out there, like I said, to version with this guy named Brasco, then Chamillionaire, obviously. So the fact that Chamillionaire's album just took off like that, and it was my first platinum plaque, and I was like, hey, you know, I thank my manager, Tony Perez, for actually staying loyal to Universal and keeping that track, because look what happened, you know, and being something that was a part of something that I made history. So I was glad that this album, I think it's like 1.5, means so far, almost double platinum, which is crazy. So it was my first platinum plaque, you know, it was on the Sound of Revenge, and I just could thank, you know, Chamillionaire, man. And I just remember when I saw like the first video for Turn It Up, I just knew he was a different artist, something new, you know, the Koopa chain, you know, the little, you know, chameleon crawling on the ground, you know. I was just like, this guy is just like, and he was so cocky, like he was just like in the videos and stuff, he just knew that he was gonna be that guy. Ended up being that guy. So shout out to Chamillionaire. This is Hardley Davidson checking out Burner Rubber Studios. This is the HD Constructed episode 2. We will see you on the next one. Who knows what I'm gonna talk about next. Holla at your boy. Your flow. Run, go get your city, come back, then I'm gon' bury your area code. Ain't running from the pain, cause I ain't never been a punk. Drama and the pain, cause I can bring it if they won't. I'ma let it bang, so they can feel it enough. In the trunk, body with your gang. Decide your record, throw it up. What you tryna drink? Cause I'm about to get you drunk. Keep it pimpin', man.